Dear students, welcome to chapter 6, polynomials. In this chapter, we mainly have three subtopics, which is 6.1, polynomials, 6.2, remainder theorem, factor theorem, and zeros of polynomials, 6.3, partial fractions. In this video, we will be focusing on the subtopic 6.1, polynomials. The learning outcomes in 6.1 is perform addition, subtraction, and multiplication of polynomials. The second learning outcome is perform division of polynomials. Next, let's look at example 3. Given px is x square minus x minus 1 and qx is 2x cubed minus x square plus 1, determine 4qx. So this is scalar multiplication of a polynomial. So 4 multiply qx, I'm going to write 4 in bracket. Qx is 2x to the power of 3 minus x to the power of 2 plus 1. So we will be getting 8x to the power of 3 minus 4x to the power of 2 plus 4. So scalar multiplication is much simple compared to multiplication of two polynomials. Next, we're going to look at multiplication of two polynomials, which is px multiply qx. So what happens when px multiply qx? First, we're going to write down our px, which is x to the power of 2 minus x minus 1, followed by qx, which is 2x cubed minus x square plus 1. When we are dealing with multiplication, we must make sure every term in px multiplies every term in qx. So first, we're going to start with the first term, which is x square. So we're going to make sure x square multiplies with every term in qx. So x square times 2x cubed, we will be getting 2x to the power of 5, followed by negative x to the power of 4, followed by positive x square. So this is what happens when you take the first term and you try to multiply with every term in your second polynomial. Next, we're going to focus on the second term, which is negative x. So we're going to make sure negative x multiplies with every term of your qx. So negative x multiplies 2x cubed, we will be getting negative 2x to the power of 4, followed by negative x multiply negative x square, positive x cubed, and negative x multiply 1 is negative x, and the last term is negative 1. Now we're going to make sure negative 1 multiplies with every term of your qx. So negative 1 multiply 2x cubed, we will be getting negative 2x cubed, followed by negative 1 multiply negative x square, we will be getting positive x square. Negative 1 multiply positive 1, we will be getting negative 1. Okay students, next we're gonna rearrange from the highest power. So the highest power is 2x to the power of 5, followed by negative x to the power of 4 and negative 2x to the power of 4, followed by power 3, positive x to the power of 3, followed by negative 2x to the power of 3. Next, we're going to focus on x to the power of 2. So we will start with positive x to the power of 2, followed by positive x to the power of 2. And next is x. So we only have negative x, and constant term, we only have negative 1. So the last is we're going to simplify our answer. So 2x to the power of 5 minus 3x to the power of 4 minus x to the power of 3 plus 2x to the power of 2 minus x minus 1. So this is slightly tedious compared to addition, subtraction or scalar multiplication. So I hope you can understand. The more exercise you do, the more simple it will become. Now these are the exercises that we have for multiplication. Okay students, I hope you have achieved our first learning outcome from our first subtopic, which is polynomials. I hope that all of you are able to multiply polynomials. That's all for today. Thank you students.